It's your boy, Famous Animal TV. Who I got in the building with me?
Man, Heavy Hustle, man. Represent Black Haven, Memphis, Tennessee, man. Stand up.
Memphis? You coming out of Memphis with this shit?
Yeah, all the way out there.
So like, you coming out of Black Haven? Like, so like, what got you doing this music shit?
Man, I've been doing the music, man, since I can remember, G. It started off even like instrumentation type thing. Started off that way, jumped into the making beats and came to rapping. Gave everything else up, started rapping. Found my ability in that part of it, so I've been doing it since then.
So like, you were making beats before you were rapping?
Yeah, started making beats first. Little Fruit Loop shit, you know, like everybody else started off with bullshit Fruit Loop, jumping on there. Did good with that for a minute, but then, you know, you gotta start making your own music. You know, the beats by itself, I can't sell, so I started out like that.
Real talk. So like, who inspired you to do the music? Did a rapper inspire you?
Man, to really start, I can't even say it was a rapper. Really start, man, just music. Hearing it.
I'm saying, like, yeah, who you grew up listening to?
I grew up listening to shit, Fly.
Fly
was number one. Fly used to be number one in my book. After Fly, we go to Lil Infamous. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people don't mention Infamous, but Infamous was an influence for real to me, man. Listen to folks who current now, like Swift the Track. They've been doing their shit for a long time in Memphis. You know, shout out to LC and Chicken. They've been doing their thing for a minute. Mob Stars. You know, a lot of folks from the M don't even remember that. Black Haven Bread, one of my favorite projects coming out the M. So,
Real talk. So like the shit that you get out now and the music that you're doing now, like what category can you put it in? Like you coming on some trap shit, some gangster shit? Like
it's street music, but
street music, but
it's a different type of street music. So you got everybody talking about trap shit. Yeah, everybody done did that. You know that story getting old. I talk about real shit. You know what I'm saying? So you think about it from a perspective of everybody that make it a big time dope boy. Everybody started selling dope at one point in time. They started working jobs. I give you that perspective, you know what I'm saying? I done been out there and did all the other shit too, just like everybody else. They come with part of the nature of where we from. But at the end of the day, you gotta move on and start doing other shit. So I started talking about street music from my perspective, you know what I'm saying? Growing up in the seeing certain shit, doing certain shit, you know what I'm saying? I speak out from my point of view, no fabrication in it.
Like, all right, so like, growing up like out of Memphis and you know, growing up out of like, you know, Black Haven and all that type shit, like, what's the most crazy shit you ever seen, like growing up?
Man, craziest shit I ever seen. Man, it had to be them goddamn fights from the mound, man. Them niggas was raised in hell back in the day, right? Coming through the shell and shit like that.
Yeah.
Like seeing niggas getting their life down there, taking from getting beat out that motherfucker. Premier days and shit like that. Niggas getting drugged out that motherfucker halfway dead. So, you know what I'm saying? Them had to be some of the craziest shit. Little bullshit shootouts, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, at the same time, then nobody died no motherfucker. Niggas just be shooting everywhere, just say they shot something.
Have you ever been in the middle of a shootout growing up in Memphis?
No, I ain't never been in the middle of one. You know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't never had to do a couple things, but I ain't never been in the middle of a shootout, though.
Yeah. Tell us, like, what made you leave Memphis and come to Atlanta?
Man, chasing the dream, G. Like, really trying to make some more connections, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know everybody in Memphis, they kind of get to a certain point, you know what I'm saying? At a certain point in time, we got to leave Memphis. And spread the story, you know what I'm saying? You can't represent Memphis in Memphis all the time, you know what I'm saying? So I took that approach to it and left Memphis, went to Dallas first, made connections out there, you know, just networking, you know what I'm saying? Not even really big names, but folks who making moves, you know what I'm saying? Videographers, marketing people who help push your career further. Same thing I came down here for.
Real talk. So, like, who was the biggest person that you done bumped into or ran across?
My biggest person.
Rapper, anybody.
Rapper-wise, anybody. Cat One, Blue Da Vinci, Killer Kaleon, we went out to Houston.
Okay, yeah.
Killer Kaleon before, you know what I mean?
Boy, Killer?
Yeah, one of my top rappers, so you know what I'm saying? Like, ran across a lot of people out here.
Real talk. So, like, when you running across them, is you doing music with them? Like,
no, it ain't even no music shit. It, you know, most times, like, I met Cat One and Blue Da Vinci in the club. You know what I'm saying? Just nigga having fun.
Vibing.
I'm showing out And you know, real niggas just show love. You know what I'm saying? That's just how that happened. It's just a mutual thing that happened. You know what I'm saying? Wasn't even on no music shit, no fan shit. You know, some of these niggas out here take this shit as fan shit when you approach them with the music thing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So it's just been legitimate meetups with folks.
Real talk. So like, who would you wanna meet or who would you wanna work with or who would you think you can put a good project together with?
Man, good project, I have to say Iceberg.
Iceberg?
Iceberg out of Florida, man. Like, that's one of my top five. You know what I'm saying? Like, Iceberg or a Nipsey Hussle. You know what I'm saying? Something like that.
Nipsey? So, like, I'm saying, like, is you coming on some, like, some West Coast music type shit? Like, on some Nipsey shit?
No, it's Memphis, but it's the same type of shit Nipsey's doing, though. Nipsey music still street. It just ain't all trap based. You know what I'm saying? So it's still street music. You still being descriptive about where you coming from. You still being descriptive about what you done been through and what you done did. It's the same shit.
Mm-hmm. Real talk, real talk. So like, have somebody ever compared you to another rapper?
Man, the comparisons I done got been old cats, they say Pimp C.
Pimp C?
I don't hear that part, but you know what I'm saying? But the older cats say Pimp C. In Memphis, a lot of people compare it to All Star or Starlito now. You know what I mean? I still say All Star because, you know, I'm just day one fan of the shit.
Real talk. So, like, how do you take that shit when people compare you to, you know, legendary rappers or rappers, period?
Man, shit, it's a blessing. It make you want to go harder. You know what I'm saying? You gotta be compared to something if it's already been done before. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, so I just take it as a blessing, man, and appreciate it.
Real talk. So, like, which one of your projects you feel is though one of your best projects, and it'll make people listen to the rest of your music?
Man, I say, you know, everybody say the same shit. They say their current project, but it's really the truth. I got my latest project out, Hieroglyphs. I dropped it in January. Hieroglyphs going stupid. You know what I'm saying?
It's going stupid?
Two involved doing numbers on YouTube, doing good numbers, you know, good organic numbers. And I got a record called Color of the Night off this same project. It's talking about Memphis, you know what I'm saying? They talk about their real street shit and the political side, everything, shit like that. But Hieroglyphs, if you listen to that one project, you'll be stuck on the music.
Real talk. So like I'm saying, so like if they go listen to it, like what type of feeling would you get from a vibe? Would you be bouncing to it? Would you be just laid back thinking? Like,
it's the best way to think about it. You got hieroglyphs, the meaning of hieroglyphs. When you think about hieroglyphs, you think about writing on the wall. You think about old Egyptian shit. Well, the whole point of that whole project is, what I'm talking about, you're going to visualize pictures. You're going to visualize these scenes. You can listen to a song and visualize everything I done said. That's what you can't do with a lot of folk music. And that's what I'm giving back to the street.
Mm-hmm. Real talk. That's what's up. So, like, you know, What's your whole point of doing this music? Is it for the money? Like, is it, you know what I'm saying, to get the money, just for the money?
Nah, everything, you know, the money is a bonus, bro. You know what I'm saying? This is passion. This is what I want to do. You know what I'm saying? So the money shit is a bonus. You know what I'm saying? Everybody, of course, we all want to get paid for what we do. But at the same time, this is just a passion, you know what I'm saying, of mine.
Mm-hmm. Real talk. You know, I ain't going to hold you up. You know what I'm saying? I know you got to get back to it. But, like, is there anything, like, do you got a message for doing this music shit?
Man, my message in the music, really, bro, don't believe everything you hear. You know what I'm saying? It's different sides to this shit. You know what I'm saying? If you're going to listen to some music, listen to some shit that you actually relate to. And I feel like I'm giving it to everybody. You know what I'm saying? Whether you a nigga who been in the street 10 years or you a nigga who's scared of the street. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Shit like that. I want you to get that whole picture. I want you to get that image. And don't feel fucked up about what you're doing. A lot of people put a negative stigma when you say street music. Now, street music is what hip hop was based off of, period. You know what I'm saying? So we just talk about our story.
Mm-hmm. Real talk. Give me a couple of videos you got out.
All right, videos. I got Color of the Night. Color of the Night, my latest video. Need to check this joint out, going on YouTube right now. Two Involved. It's the single. That's the single right now. I got that one on iTunes. Got it on Spotify. Every major digital platform. You can go check this joint out right now too.
Mm-hmm. So like, do you shoot a video to every single you put out?
Every single we do, we're gonna shoot a video for it. Hell, I'm gonna get to the whole point where we're gonna shoot a video for every song. You know what I'm saying? So when I go out, I'm gonna be flying out to Thailand in a week. We're gonna try to get a video done out there.
Yeah, real talk. So like, I'm saying, like, how could they keep up with you to know when you're going to drop these videos?
Man, follow me right now, man. Heavy Hustle 901. Heavy Hustle 901 on everything. Facebook, IG, YouTube, whatever. Type in Heavy Hustle 901. You can link up with me.
Real talk. So, like, is you a big fan of doing features?
Man, feature whenever, dog. Hit the line. Go to my IG. The email right there. My Black Roses Music Group at gmail.com. Link up with me. I got features for you all day long, man. And I'm going to give you a real verse. No bullshit.
Real talk.
I was hurt being faithful, so when I see an ex, I think I can't get too involved. Love me for what? Baby, we fought for forever. You should just fuck me for Nancy. You start doing better. You should just start with the pressure. Please, swear I won't let up. My ex fucked my head up. A heartbreaker too. Cool, breathe. My heart unsuccessful.